the table, fans. Extra purpley demon fire of happiness to you today. I'm excited today because Amberlee's here. Oh, and she just painted up this Necron army. This is middle of the road BTP Wargamer standard, level 3 out of 10. So respectable. And the best bang for your buck, as far as I'm concerned, it's about 3,000 points. I'm going to actually get this all out and show it to you in the next, I don't know, week or so. But Amberlee just showed up. You just painted a Necron army. How do you feel?
Tired?
Yeah, you've got mixed feelings.
Yes.
Because you just painted this giant Necron army.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit about the colors and techniques that you used, and you know, maybe some of the interesting things about the project.
Well, I started off black primer. Then okay. I did a teal overspray.
Okay.
Then I took foul green and did a dry brush. Then I did deep purple with the airbrush going into with the glow.
Right.
Then I did magenta for the glow, and then
is that an ink or actually a Vallejo color, magenta?
Oh.
You're just saying what the color is rather than...
The color, the actual...
Okay, got it. It's probably a Warlord purple.
Yes, it's Warlord purple.
That's one of my faves. Okay, and then what?
And then a mix between the Warlord purple and just white for the highlight.
Okay, great.
And then just a yellow highlight, that's the sun yellow, and then some copper
and
also.
Hold on just a second. Because we're about to run out of juice here on the camera. I really like the little yellow points here, and that's something we discussed when you were in midway through the project, kind of see how it was going. And it because it provides sort of this subtle counterpoint, you know, like on this. It's not a lot, but it's there. Anyway, go ahead. And you said copper? I don't see any copper on this. It's all like dark gray.
It's on just a few things, like on a few for
okay, like the metallics thing. Like it's over here too on this. On this monolith.
Few. So like for the level 4s, it's on some of the metal. I mean, just on, you can't see it very well there.
No, I love this. This is great.
Yeah.
Like that little bit of yellow really makes a big difference.
So it's just on like the highlight,
right.
just for the insignias, just barely.
Okay, great. Well, I'm gonna show, I'm gonna show this army off in its great splendor. And a conversion. So we got these two tomb stalkers in. We made this one into a tomb sentinel. But the little ropey sort of antennae, those come from this Tesseract Vault kit, because as an interior portion. And I think it just looks so good. The normal antenna just break off so easy and are a little weak. And so I think this makes them look very insectoid. And
those were pretty good to handle. With this army, you have to be very careful. Just handle with care as you're painting, especially with these guys.
Right.
You are just like that when you're painting. You just are so careful when you paint. And when you're storing, they can get tangled so easy. So just store with care. But they're so beautiful to paint. And rather, I don't want to say easy, but they paint nice. So when you brush it, everything pops.
Right.
And you can
just see.
They
have some pretty hard edges.
Yeah. So if you brush it, you start seeing everything. And it just comes out so nicely. So it's a fun army. It's been my favorite.
Well, fantastic. And I really have to tip my hat to you for getting this done. This will be a special treat for our guests up at Valhalla this week. We're very excited. Thank you, Amberlee.
Thank you.